Hello. In this video, I'll show you how to take one of these three-speed fans with the latching buttons. To that, we're going to add a Sonoff Basic and a two-port relay. And the combination of the relay in the Sonoff and the two relays on the module will replace the function of these buttons to change the speed of the fan. So these fans work by mains coming in, going to the input of this three-position switch. And every time you push a button, it connects mains to either one of these three. Those in turn are three of the four wires that go up the stem to the head of the fan, the fourth one being the neutral. So what I did was I cut these wires off and I've left a little bit of the color on each one just so I can keep a reference of which speed each one of these colors is. So the next job is preparing the Sonoff. As usual, I put the sockets on there for it makes it easier to program. And then on the back, I'm doing something slightly different to what I normally do. Normally I'd come off the bottom pin here, which is 3.3 volts. Someone mentioned in one of the comments, and I'll leave a link in the description for him, that pin there is half wave rectified 5 volts. So there's a nice 5 volts DC supply available on a Sonoff. 5 volts coming down on the yellow. I've got obviously a black on the ground. And then I've used white and red, is the same colors as speed 2 and speed 3 on the fan. And then I'll connect speed 1, blue, to the actual Sonoff relay itself. So coming off the white and the red, I'm going to be using one of these two relay modules, one for each of the two speeds. You also see there's a couple of 10k resistors here. I found that if I'm running 5 volts off the Sonoff, the signals coming out of the GPIO ports get a bit messed up. Those two 10k resistors have sorted that out, so these are necessary if you're running off of the 5 volts off the Sonoff. So the next job is to connect these two together. I've already prepared my wires by adding some heat shrink links to them. This one here on the right is VCC, and that one is our yellow wire coming off the 5 volts. Okay, next one, I'll take the grounds. That's the last pin on this board. Speed 1 is white, and on the board, that's that first channel there. And then finally, red onto our second connector. Okay, and then we'll just pull the heat shrink down over all of these just to keep them nicely apart. And then a lick of heat from our lighter. So with that done, we are ready to program the Sonoff and get it tested. And the input boolean itself, input boolean there, and I've got one for fans. And this one, small fan, small underscore fan, that keeps the same naming conventions. And I've just called it small fan. It has an MDI icon of the fan there. And as you can see, that's in here. In ESPHome, I've called this one small fan. And I've also using substitutions because I use the same code for all my fans. So in here, I've given it a substitutions, the name of name with the value of small underscore fan. This has to be lowercase and with no spaces. And this is the name of the ESPHome device. And also some of the IDs that you can see highlighted here. Also using an input boolean in Home Assistant, this enables me to turn on and off the fan using just a simple switch. So the input boolean comes in, I give it the same name for each fan. So in this case, this will be input boolean dot small underscore fan. What I've done here is I've done on press, then turn on relay 1, which is speed 1. However, if I turn this input boolean off, then on release, turn all three relays off. Now the three relays themselves, including the relay 1 down here, GPIO 12, that's the internal pin on the Sonoff for the onboard relay. Now because I only want one relay on at a time, or one speed selected at a time, we use the interlock. And that would mean only one of these relays can be on at a time. We do that simply by doing interlock group name. So in this case I've called it interlock group because I've only got one, and that consists of a list. So it's relay 1, relay 2, relay 3, which is all three. Underneath that I have an interlock wait time. Now this is 300 milliseconds, and what that does is it puts a delay between turning off one relay and turning on the next. So when one goes off, there's a slight delay before it turns the next one on. So we just need interlock group with a list of the relays in that group. So relay number 2, so name small fan space 2, which is GPIO 1, that's the TX pin on the Sonoff. We'll invert that because of the way the relay boards work. I'll give it an icon, fan, called it relay 2, added it to the interlock group, and again we have the same 300 milliseconds. And then that's exactly the same thing for GPIO3, which is RX on the Sonoff, and you'll see that everything is exactly the same apart from relay 3 and the number 3 there in its name. Finally, I'll just do the status LED on this board. I've taken it off, but I leave it in there for other boards. So we'll save that, we'll upload it. Next thing we'll do is have a look at that input boolean. So that input boolean for me is one of these buttons, and I can turn off the input boolean on and off here. Relay 1 would come on, and regardless what speed the fan is sitting at, so that's relay 1, 2 or 3 on, this will turn off all three of them, as we've shown in the on release. Next thing we need to do is test it. So I've got mains coming in, and we'll also have a look at the code coming out of their small fan device. So if we turn it on relay 1, that was the Sonoff relay going on and off. Relay 2 will be one of these two. Fan 2 coming on and off, and then fan 3. So for the interlocking, if I turn on this one, you'll see fan 1 has come on. If I then turn on speed 2, these buttons will go immediately, but you'll see here a slight delay of when the fan 1 goes off and fan 2 comes on. That's like a third of a second. And in here, and then if we go back to Home Assistant, and then the small fan here, if I push it, you'll see speed 1 come on here and back off again. You can see it's turned off speeds 1, 2, and 3. If I turn it back on again, you'll see speed 1. If I go back to here and tell it to do speed 3, and if I turn it off, it sends the off state to all three. So regardless of what speed it's on, this will always turn off that fan. Okay, so that all works. It's time to install it into our fan now. Switch off the mains, take your plug out. Next thing I need to do is get this in there, but first of all we need to connect it up. I've taken off the mains by here because I'm going to need to get mains to this board. So I'm going to take a piece of wire that I've taken out from something else, and we'll strip that off, and then I'm going to connect that to the mains coming in. Again, safety first, this wire is unplugged. Cut that off about there. Add these two into the input side, and then what I like to do is rip the wire just a little bit, check it, make sure nothing's sticking out, and then you can tighten it fully. Now in the live video I showed putting the wire in like that and then coming back out again. That's not the best thing to do. The best thing to do is get yourself a little terminal block and split the wire that way. So make sure I've got enough wire for the length, so we'll cut that about there. Again, I'm gonna fold that, give it a little blob of solder. I'll put that in one side of there. Again, tighten it a little bit, make sure that it's connected nicely. Do it nice and tight. And then this one, I want to take two wires out of here. So we'll chop that off. And then we'll put that, both of those ends now in there. So I don't need a lot of wire coming out of there, so we'll cut that off there. And then we'll strip both of these. Again, I like to solder these. You'll see on the relays, you've got the common, which is this little bar here. So as you can see at the moment, that little bar is connected to that one. So when the relay comes on, that little bar there switches over to this side. Our contacts, we want the bar and what's known as the normally open. So our mains will go into the two center ones there. Check they're all in there. Right, with that connected, we just need to connect the fan to the Sonoff. Now the neutral wire from the stem, that's goes into our Sonoff, into the neutral. So that's the neutral in. So the blue here is speed 1. As we said, speed 1 is now the relay on the Sonoff. Tighten it right down, and while we're here we'll put the cap on. Speed 2 is white, so the white one into the top there. Tighten it up, and then finally the red wire again soldered and tighten it up. We can test the setup once again just to make sure before we put it all back together. Yes, I did forget to put the cable through the hole first, so I've rerouted that. Little bit of hot glue in the four corners of the relay boards, just to stick that to the case, stop it from flapping about. And then I like to put the Sonoff in the stem, just keeps it out of the way, keeps it nice and neat. And there you go. We put it back together and put it back on the shelf. Now we have our fan converted and controllable with Home Assistant. Let's make it a little bit smart. So in my setup, I have two thermostats, one for cooling and one for heating. And these are connected together. So whenever I change the temperature on this one, that one replicates it. So what we can do is we can take the difference between what the temperature in the room is to what the thermostat is set to. And depending on that difference, change the speed of the fan. Now, while we can get this temperature in, because this is a combination of sensors that pick up the temperature in the room, this is an attribute of the thermostat itself. So in order to get that, we have to make a separate sensor out of it. We do that in sensors in Home Assistant. So here I've got thermo temperature, and this is the thermostat temperature. And here I'm just calling it thermostat, and I'm taking the state attribute of the first thermostat. So in my case, it's climate bedroom cooling. And then I'm taking the attribute of temperature and I'm feeding that number into a sensor called thermostat. So in the ESPHome code, here's that thermostat there. It's a sensor thermostat. And then internally, I give this an ID of thermo. And you can see it's highlighted here where it's been used. And then secondly, I bring in this case, the sensor for bedroom temperature. And that's the same sensor that this is reading here. So the condition is on value. So when this sensor bedroom temperature gets updated, it looks at the following conditions. So if, and I'm using an and here, so all three of these need to be true. So first of all, the binary sensor, is the binary sensor on? And that is the binary sensor here. Next, we need to measure the temperature difference. We're looking at the state of temp, which is the ID for the bedroom temperature. So if that is above the thermostat state, so that's this number here, whatever I set it to. If it's above that by 0 degrees, then that's true. And it has to be below the temperature by 3 degrees. So our first condition here, if all three of these are true, switch on relay one. So that's speed one of the fan. Our second if statement, again, if the sensor is on, if it's between 3.1 and 5, then relay two comes on. And then finally, if it's on, it's above by any more than 5.1 degrees, then relay three comes on, and that's speed three. So finally, we want an off condition, and I'm using OR here for this one. So if the binary sensor is off, or if the temperature is less than the thermostat state minus half a degree. So if the room temperature gets below the thermostat setting by half a degree, it turns off the relays. Now you can do all this in scripts, in Home Assistant and Node-RED, but I like to put this sort of code distributed around the devices, so in this case, actually on the Sonoff itself. Well, I hope this video was helpful with your projects. Please do share it so others can find it as well. I upload videos whenever I can, so subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified. That's it. Thanks for watching.